narrow role, my own mandate is to make sure farmers get cost-effective technologies. And myself as a pathologist, I feel I need to provide a solution to the farmers. First of all, if you could look at where we are now in this zone, potato is so loved in a manner that it is taken as a farmer's wallet. It is a food crop, it is an income or a cash crop, meaning that every farmer in this region treasures it so much. And in terms of nutritional composition, it is the most well-balanced food crop. In terms of cash, it's the only crop that you can actually raise in 90 days. And within a few days, you have the food, you have the money. Potato as a crop has many challenges, but key of those are diseases. And in particular, we have one major disease called late blight. When this disease attacks, farmers lose 40 to 60% of their yield. When you translate this loss in terms of economic terms as a country, in Ugandan shillings we are losing close to 500 billion in a year. And the fact that most of these farmers, actually are small scale farmers owning very small lands, and with minimal capacity to control the disease, because in a normal farming system, they have to manage it using chemicals. So they lose money in the form of chemical sprays. They lose money in the form of buying the fungicides. When you compute the costs of the chemicals, at country level, we are losing close to 17 billion just in that process of spraying, trying to manage the disease. Everybody is looking up to that day. When you just plant a crop and the crop grows to your expectation, gives you yield without you having any costs added to it in terms of chemical sprays. So we partnered with the International Potato Center. Through that kind of collaboration, we were able to precisely move genes that could actually protect this Victoria. And we have been able to test this product here for several cycles, now close to over 10 tests in the field. So the 3R potato that we are referring here is a variety of Victoria in which three resistant genes, which were selectively selected from the relatives of the potato and transferred into our local Victoria and evaluated, and has proved to be resistant to late blight. These genes have been used previously in other varieties of potato which we eat, and therefore it is safe. And in the process of evaluation, we do actually all the checks to make sure at least by the time we avail it, we have done all the tests that are required from us by the legal framework, because whatever we do is under the regulation of the National Biosafety Committee to make sure that these farmers obtain safe materials. I look forward for this product reaching to the farmer, because this is a product that can help the farmer actually save a lot of money, get more yields, because we believe if a farmer adopts this variety, he will improve his income by over 10%. His yield will increase by 40%. That would be a lot of money coming to his pocket. He will have food on the table, and that would be a major, tremendous impact on the livelihood in the potato farmer in this zone. And I look forward for that day when every farmer is smiling and enjoying and is growing the cereal potato.